ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله منا فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه، وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله داعي إلى رضوانه. أما بعد، إخوتي في الله، أيها الآباء الكرام وأمهات الفضليات، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى قائلا في كتابه بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. All thanks and praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, the Lord of the universe. We thank him. And of course, as Muslims, we do testify that there is none worthy of worship and praise except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is the final and seal of all prophets and messengers Allah sent to guide mankind from the darkness of disobedience towards the nur of Iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst the guided ones, say Kareem.
Ameen.
My dear brothers and sisters in the deen, fathers as well as mothers, I first of all admonish myself standing before you and all of you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. He called on you to believe and say, O you who believe, اتقوا الله حق تقاته. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he ought to be feared. ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. And do not die except in the state of Islam. أيها الفاضل، my dear brothers and sisters in the deen، خلقت هذه الدنيا فتانا غرارا. This world is created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but also full or filled with trials and deception. The world is filled with trials and deception. وَأَنَا وَأَنْتْ وَهُوَ وَهِ. Me and you, he, she, all of us, نُسَارِع. We are competing في هذه الدنيا to earn this world. وَتَرَكْنَا الْآخِرَ وَرَاءَنَا. And we take this world, I mean the hereafter, put it behind us. That's the problem. نُسَارِعُ فِي الدُّنْيَا بِالْهَوَى وَالنُّفُوسِ وَالشَّهَوَاتِ وَالشَّيْطَانِ. We competing to earn this dunya with our desire, our wants, with shaitan. And we forgot that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with a dustur constitution. With a dustur constitution that if we take to that constitution, we abide by it, then the world will be a suitable world for us and the hereafter will be the place of abode for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst those who take or abide by this constitution Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. And that constitution is the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this Quran to myself and all of you, the entire ummah. Allah said in the Quran, He said, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. That book, and that is the Quran, Allah referring to the Quran, لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. There is no doubt in it. هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It's guidance, it's a guide that leads me and you to the straight path. It's a guidance for those who are God conscious. That book, it's a guidance for those who are God conscious. If that be the case, my dear brothers and sisters, today we left the Quran. Namdi Aksatia. We are going the opposite direction. The Muslims, or majority of the Muslims, are going the opposite direction of their Quran and Sunnah. The opposite direction. In terms of character, in terms of ibadah, in terms of the deen, in terms of da'wah, We are going the opposite direction. That's the problem today we are facing. عجباً. Amazing. لأمر هذه الدنيا. The life, the aspect of this dunya. And that's why the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, والله, he said by Allah, لا الفقر أو ما الفقر أخشى عليكم. He said, I'm not afraid for poverty on you. I'm not afraid for you to be poor. No. He's not afraid about poverty. He said, ولكن أخشى أن تبسط عليكم الدنيا كما بسطت على الذين من قبلكم. He said, I am afraid for this world to be stretched towards you. This world to be given, presented towards you. فتنافسوها. And you will compete for this world. كما تنافسوها. He said, ولكن أخشى أن تبسط عليكم الدنيا كما بسطت على الذين من قبلكم. He said, I'm afraid for this world to be stretched towards you, presented to you, just like the way it was given or stretched to those before you. فتنافسوها. You will compete for it. You will compete for this dunya. كما تنافسوها. Just like those before you competed for this world. فتهلككم كما أهلكتهم. And at the end of the day, as a result, the world will destroy you. Just like the way it destroyed those before you. In other words, you will leave this dunya without any values, without any tangible results for you to earn or hold along with you, to take along with you to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah save us from that fitna, ya kareem.
Amen.
Many brothers and sisters, حينما دخل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المدينة, when the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم entered المدينة from Mecca, عرض على الأنصار الإسلام. He presented the deen, the da'wah, to the people of Medina, the Ansar. When he did that, فَجَاءَ الْأَنْصَارُ أَفْوَاجًا. The Ansar, they came to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in groups, multitude. يعلنون الشهادة في حضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. They all testifying, saying the shahada, accepting Islam, welcoming the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. ما من بيت من بيوت الأنصار في المدينة إلا ودخل فيه نور الهداية. There isn't a house, a home, from the houses of the Ansar, Ridwanullah alayhim, except that house we receive the nur of Iman, of Islam, because they accepted Allah. Illa, except a man. That man is called Usayr ibn Abi Ashhal. Usayr, he did not accept the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He did not accept the deen at that time. Kana karihan lil Islam. He hated Islam so much. Wa kana saddan an da'wati Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to be an obstacle for the da'wah to be spread amongst the Muslims. Usayr. حتى خرج رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى الأحد. Until the time when the battle of Uhud occurred, the Rasul and the Sahabas, the believers, they came out for the battle of Uhud. حصل ما حصل. جرى ما جرى. Whatever happened, at that time happened. وَبِمَشِيئَةِ اللَّهِ. Through the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قَذَفَ الْهِدَايَةِ فِي قَلْبِ عُسَيْرٍ. And through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's permission, Usayr accepted Islam. في غزوة الأهد. He accepted the deal. And what happened? That man who accepted the deal at that moment, listen to this, at that moment, Usayr accepted the deal. وتقلد بسيفه أو سيفه واندس مع الصفوف ليقاتل في صف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And at that moment, he had his own machete. And then he joined the believers. The same row of the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم battling, fighting for this deen. ومات شهيدا. That man died in the path of the deen as shaheed, as a martyr. لم يسجد لله سجدة. He did not prostrate, not a prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he accepted Islam. ودخل الجنة. And he entered الجنة. يا لها من لهذا. What a moment. يا لها من عبرة. What a lesson. تصور يا أخي الكريم. كان كثيرا. Plenty of time. Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه. He will mention this to say, رجل من أهل الجنة. He will say, a man amongst the people of الجنة, the dwellers of الجنة. لم يسجد لله سجدة. Did not prostrate to Allah a prostration. He did not worship, put this forehead on the surface of this earth. ولكن الله تبارك وتعالى من عليه. Allah سبحانه وتعالى blessed him. ساعات أو ساعة واحدة. Just an hour, a moment. Just an hour or one moment. 1 hour of your moment, of your life, of your worldly time or period. One will make use of that time. And that time will overcome all his life that he has spent in his dunya, in disobedience, and take him to Al-Jannah. Al-Ibra, the lesson we need to learn, what we need to ponder over, here al-Khatima, the ending, not the beginning. The end justifies your direction. The end justifies your place of abode. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us good ending. من brothers and sisters in the deen. تصور هذا الرجل كان بالأمس كارها لرسول الله. This man yesterday, he hated the رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was an obstacle of this deen. And here, he is today, he is a way to establish the deen. He's a man that took the lead to enter Al-Jannah. إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَهْدِي مَنْ أَهْبَرْتِ. You will never guide the person you love. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. But it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who grants guidance to whomever he will. لَوْ كَانَ الْهِدَايَةِ تَأْتِي مِنْ عِنْدِ الْإِنسَانِ لَهَدَى رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَمَّهِ. If one has the ability to guide mankind, to make them a believer, then the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم would have guided his uncle and gave him hidayah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear to him and all of us that you will not guide the person you love. Guidance came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Guidance came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Umar ibn Khattab رضي الله عنه. عمر, all of us know the history of Umar. Umar radiallahu anhu كان يقول he used to say دلني على محمد قال me show me to محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم لأقتله for me to kill him for me to take his soul that's what Umar radiallahu anhu used to do he would say take me to محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم so I can take his soul I can kill him On his way going, what happened? He met someone who asked him, Ya Umar, where are you going to? He said, I am going to kill Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said to him, before you go and clean someone else's house, yeah, you go and kill someone, then start from your own house, hold. Your sister is a Muslim. Go and deal with her first before you deal with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But eventually, when he returned back to his, when he went to his sister, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used that as sabab, as means for his hidayah, for him to gain guidance, hidayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what happened. غلام يهودي a young man a Jew from the Bani Israel young man يهودي كان خادما لرسول الله he used to be a servant serving the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يكن مسلما he was not a Muslim افتقده رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't see this man, this young gentleman, for a few days. يومين أو ثلاثة. Two or three days, according to the reports. And then he asked about him. He said, what about this young man? Brothers and sisters, we are not just narrating these stories for us to listen to them, but it's for us to learn from it, to see how the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam treated believers and non-believers. Because the Umar ibn Khattab, he used to say, كُنْ دَاعِيَ بِلَا حَدِيثِ بِلَا كَلَامِ He said, invite people into the deen without a word, without a statement. And then they asked, they said, يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ How can that happen? How can I invite someone into Islam without saying a word. And then Umar ibn Khattab said, he said, بأخلاقك, through your character, your manners, when you talk, talk as a Muslim. When you look as a Muslim. When you touch as a Muslim. Let the Quran be your constitution. Let the Sunnah The teachings of the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم be your path. من يطيع الرسول فقد أطاع الله. Anyone who obeyed the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he or she has obeyed Allah. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. You've got the greatest example. The greatest example, the best role model for you to implement in your life. And that is the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ghulamun Yahudi. Let's go back to it. A Jew, young man, youth, who used to be with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Rasul never shouted at him. He never hit him. No. Never the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam hit that man or even swear at him. Nah. That's not the Rasul. At all. That man was ill. And then they told him, they said, Ya Rasulullah, innahu yashku. He's complaining that he's unwell. And the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, show me his house. Take me there.
I want to visit him. How many amongst us, we have our neighbors, they are non-Muslims. Do we visit them? Rather, you know what I say? No, it's kuffar. They know how to say it. MashaAllah. They know it. They say it's kuffar. Ya akhi al-kareem. We are living in a society where me and you have a great role, a greater role to play, to teach them Islam, to make them accept the deen when they see the way we behave. When the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came to this Ghulam Yahudi, the Jew, young man, and then he sat by him. This boy, this young man was very unwell, ill. And they soon realized that he is about to approach his last moments. And then he said to him, Ya Ghulam, he said, oh young man, قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Testify, accept that there is none worthy of worship and praise except Allah. And testify that I am the messenger of Allah. And the young man will turn to his father and look at his father. And then his father said to him, Ya Bunay, oh you my dearest son, Ati Abu al-Qasim, Allahu Akbar. He said, oh you my dearest son, follow the father of Qasim. Follow him. Obey him. If the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was not a kind man, he was not a man that showed respect to the non-Muslims, would that man, that father, if he was a man that kills, is a man that is unjust, would that father, a Jewish man, will say to his son, obey him? No. But rather he said to his son, obey him. فَمَا كَانَ لِلْغُلَامِ إِلَّا أَنْ يَشْهَدْ. The ghulam, the young man, had not much to see, but rather to say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأنك رسول الله. He said, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah, and you are the messenger of Allah. فَمَاتَ عَلَى دِينِ اللَّهِ. And the young man died as a Muslim. يَا لَهَا مِنْ لَهَذَا. What a moment. What a moment. From kufr, from disobedience to Islam. All his life span, all his life period that he spent, it was in, out of the deen. But last moments, an hour, he spent it in the deen to meet Allah. Do you know your ending? Do you know what will be the end of your life? What are you celebrating? What demand, what guarantee do I have, do you have, to show that you will die as a Muslim? And that is why we have a few lessons to learn about this man. According to Ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu anhu, he said, a man called Bal'an ibn Ba'ura. This man called Bal'an, he was one of the most knowledgeable people at the time of Musa, or scholars at the time of Musa. When he sits, he has those knowledgeable ones around him writing books, volumes about him, his knowledge. But what happened? After all the knowledge Allah blessed him with, after all the hidayah Allah gave him, at the end of the day, he was manipulated by his people. Those ones who follow this dunya. And subhanAllah, they asked him, I don't want to go into the detail of the story. But they asked him, they said, first of all, one of the blessings Allah bestowed upon that man, whatever dua, supplication he made to Allah, Allah will answer. According to the narration, they said, Allah gave him so much rahmah, mercy, favor, to an extent that when he looks up, he will see the arsh, the throne of Allah. According to the narration. However, they asked him that he should call, invoke to Allah, ask Allah, make dua, supplication against Musa, alayhi salam. And he adhered to their own wishes. And when he did that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed that man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala arrested him. And Allah says in the Quran about this man, Bal'an. He said, وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا. He said, reveal the story to them. Tell them about the one that I blessed with my signs. Not just one sign. Signs, Allah said. Favors. But what happened? فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا فَأَتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانِ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ. Brother, he mishandled it. He neglected this. And then Shaitan deceived him. And from the highest of the highest, he became the lowest of all. And that's why the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, he said, إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ أَمَنْ لَيَعْمَلْ بِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ فِيمَا يَبْدُو لِلنَّاسِ. He says, sometimes a man will do good deeds, deeds of the people of Al-Jannah, the dwellers of Al-Jannah, according to the eye seen of man. Until when it comes to a moment, just a cubit between him and the Al-Jannah, a change, and he ends up in Jahannam. May Allah save us from that. While a man will continue as well from the starting of his puberty, his time, his moments, and he will reach, he will keep doing evil acts, disobeying Allah, but just a moment for him to meet Allah, and he will do good deeds and end up in Al-Jannah. That's why the Rasulullah said, إِنَّمَ الْعَمَلْ بِالْخَوَاتِمْ. Your deeds will justify, your end will justify the place of abode. If you want to know where you will be, then you will know it at the end. May Allah give us good end, Ya Kareem. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We thank Allah and the peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters in the deen, why did I mention these stories? It's for you and myself and everyone to learn that this world is not our world. We are here as visitors. And your hidayah, my hidayah, and the hidayah of someone else, guidance is not in our hands. It's in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not look down upon anyone. You don't know. You don't decide who goes to Al-Jannah and who goes to hell. No. It's not my duty. It's not your duty. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who decides. And however, before I leave this member, what will make, what will enable myself and all of you to get to a situation or to be, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, amongst those who are going to have good ending? One of the things or the most important aspects for you to be on the track is al-istiqamah, steadfastness. Allah says in the Quran, He said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ. He said, for those who say our Lord is Allah, ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. And they become steadfast. They become steadfast in the deen. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The angels will descend unto him. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. They will say to him, don't be scared. Don't have any fear. Don't be grieved. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. Be happy. Have glad tidings. For the Jannah which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised you. Now, the thabat they will have, the angels will descend unto them at the point of death. The time when they are dying, they are meeting Allah, the angels will come to them, brothers and sisters. Just a moment, listen to this. مَنْ أَحَبَّ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَ. Anyone who love meeting Allah, Allah will love meeting them. وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ كَرِهَ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَ. Whoever dislike meeting Allah, Allah will hate meeting them. And Aisha said, Ya Rasulullah, are he a monk? Is he death? Because all of us, we don't like to die, right? We dislike, we hate death. And then the Rasul said to Aisha, he said, لا يا بنت صديق. He said, not at all. He said, ولكن, I will say it in English because of time. He would say, but when a Muslim, a servant, is about to meet his Lord, if it's a good servant, the angels from Al-Jannah will descend unto him. They will show him his place of abode. And at that moment, when he sees where he is heading to, he will love meeting Allah, and Allah will love meeting them. While the evil one, when they are dying, they will show them their deeds, their evil deeds, and the evil place of abode. At that moment, they will dislike meeting Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will dislike meeting them. And the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, مَنْ كَانَ آخِرُ كَلَامِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Anyone whose last word will be before they meet Allah will be La ilaha illallah. There is none worthy of worship except Allah. And then they say that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah. They will enter Al-Jannah. You will not say it on your own, but through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy and based on the deeds, the path that you lead, that's how you will die. Man mat aasha ala shay. When you live in something with something, مات عليه, you will die upon that thing. وَمَنْ مَاتَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ بُعِثَ عَلَيْهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And when you die upon something, they will be raised with it يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our end be the best, يَا أَرْحَمَ الرَّاحِمِينَ. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واسترنا واعف عنا وتجاوز عن سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم.